Just as a disclaimer, I'm not a doctor. I do not know what I'm saying. Please don't take anything I say seriously. Do not act on any advice that I give you. What, is there anything else that I need to say? All right, first question. Hello, Miss Grossman. I was wondering as to what time period you would live in if you could choose any. I know you have your own sort of style, and if I was to guess what you would say, I'd think you'd choose the 90s. Also, nope. Anyways, have a good one. I just realized I was gonna have to read on camera, and that is something that I am not too skilled at. I just graduated from Dick and Jane. And you know, the Cat in the Hat, it's quite the mind fuck, okay? It's philosophical, it's obscure. Sam, I am. Am I Sam? Well, I'm a Jew, so probably sometime at least after the 1940s. I'm also a woman, so maybe sometime after, like, the 70s, mid-80s. And I'm very mentally ill. So, like, now times, if not the future. Hello, I am 20 years old and have graduation high school and been working fast food jobs and living with my parents. I want to stop being a loser with no friends. So, what do you think I should do? I am too dumb for college. Thanks for reading this. Sincerely, Brandon. Hi, Brandon. Well, I think you should go into dog breeding. Hear me out. You get really into mixing these things. Come up with some very obscure splicing, like the Osberger, the Huff and Whippet, and of course, the Water Border Collie. Okay, my girlfriend farted on my dick. I'm afraid that she will do it again. What do now? Well, I'll tell you what do now. First of all, get rid of your girlfriend, all right? Second, don't get another girlfriend until you grow up and become a man. Are you serious, dude? It's just gas from the ass. Hey, Jeans. Hi, Mommy. I've been writing songs for a while, and I don't know how to get them out there. I would appreciate some advice on how to put them out in a way that grabs attention, or at least doesn't make me look like a SoundCloud artist. Thanks in advance. Hope you're keeping it high and tight out there. Dylan. Thanks, Dylan. I am keeping it high and tight. Have you ever been to an art school? Because it's practically a convention center of people cosplaying as their parents' disappointment. They put on that facade because they know they're really not that good at art. So you just need to develop a very unique and explosive persona. And if your music is auditorily tolerable, that helps a lot too. Goes it. Hi, not Dr. Caroline. That's exactly right. I am not legally responsible for you. My fiance and I recently moved into a new apartment together. The landlord was very adamant about their strict no dog policy, but due to mental illness, I am prescribed an emotional support animal. Awesome. Which legally supersedes the policy in the lease. Even better. Unfortunately, due to my mental illness, I'm experiencing paralyzing anxiety about notifying the landlord about my ESA exception. What if they say no? What if they ask embarrassing questions about my mental illness? What if the dog barks and barks and all of the other tenants have to get emotional support animals to cope with all the barking? I'm sure I'd feel better with an emotional support animal, but I'm scared of an unbalanced power structure that exists between a landlord and a tenant. Valid. Not Dr. Caroline, how should I proceed? Sincerely crippled by anxiety dog needer. That's a fantastic question. First of all, I'm not gonna lie, this is no cucumber. You are in quite the pickle. First of all, I would just lie. I would tell your landlord that you need the dog because you have seizures or diabetes or it's a psychic dog that can predict earthquakes. Ultimately, tell him that you legally have standing to keep this dog, but tell him that it's life or death so he can't really question it. Also, I know a man, his name is Ativan, and change your life with the wave of a hand. And lorazepam? Please ask your doctor if this medication is right for you. What is it like to be a manic pixie dream girl? Ooh. I have to say, when I found out that that was an archetype, I was pumped. What I love about a manic pixie dream girl is that in the movie, she helps out a dude and she doesn't really get anything for herself because when she's not in the movie, she's making some big moves. Baby, it doesn't matter what's happening in Fantasyland. She's making shit happen in the real world. Am I right or am I right? Say it again, Zooey Deschanel. Zooey Deschanel is dating one of the property brothers, but she's dating the not hot one. And he also seems like he doesn't have a good personality. I don't know what the fuck is going on there. My dog ate my last Snickers bar. Perhaps it's partially my fault for leaving it out on my desk. But the dog must be punished. She may become sick from the chocolate, but that alone isn't enough. My wrath extends beyond that. However, I'm not sure how to go about teaching this asshole dog a lesson. Do you have any ideas? The dog must be somewhat intact and breathing after the sentencing is carried out. Here's what I would do. Put peanut butter on a part of its body it can't reach. Or throw it out of a slow-moving car.
Howdy, Caroline. I have to choose between going to college at two different places, so either I can confront my crippling lack of social abilities it developed from formerly undiagnosed ADHD and isolation imposed on me by my mess of a brain and the fact that no one really knows who I am because I hide myself behind the facade of constant smile and condensing my personality into weird amounts of useless knowledge and being a kid, kind of an asshole. I'm so good at reading.
Here's the thing. You're gonna go to school, you're gonna find someone that will complement your personality. Something that you need to do now is just be a loud asshole. Just be as comfortable as you can, releasing all the energy you have in social environments, even at the expense of your own self-respect. Because eventually you will find someone that will validate the true you. And I know it's easy for me to say that because I did it for many years. Everyone thought I was an asshole, but hey, it paid off, didn't it? I have no friends in the real world, but I have 500 plus emails from depressed teenagers just like myself. What are you gonna do about that? Everyone that I went to elementary school with?
This is real. This is me. I'm exactly on the right amount of amphetamines that I'm supposed to be on. Woo!
Good evening, Caroline. I noticed that you followed Ben Shapiro on Instagram. That's great. Very knowledgeable. And was wondering if there was anything I should do, being one of the few conservatives in my high school. Specifically, should I go out with someone who really disagrees with me politically and ideally? Two things. First of all, I am not a conservative. Okay, shut the fuck up. I appreciate Ben Shapiro. He speaks real good, and I don't agree with him, but he's so funny. I love him dearly. This is what I will say. People can be aggressive with their politics, and that's completely valid, but... Hello. I am an 18-year-old guy from London, and I am slowly going insane. Since being removed from all physical contact, I have become increasingly aware of how alone I am. I see people around me in relationships, and instead of being jealous, I just become sad. I am also awful at talking to women, as I never exactly been in a serious relationship or pursued one, but this means any attempt I've made in the last year to talk to girls has either ended up with me being too awkward to imply I want to be anything more than friends, or just straight up embarrassing myself, very aware I made myself out to sound like a sad sack of shit. I do have other things going on in my life, but you wanted a problem, so please advise. Sam, I am my Dan. Here's the thing. Volunteer, remotely right now, but when you can, volunteer, because volunteering is the easiest way to get laid. Manhattan Special Olympics alone has been the cause for several successful marriages and many a one-night stands. Just ask my parents. I'm kidding. Hello, Caroline. My name is Zach, and this is my Valentine's Day question. Whoops. What's the best way to ask out a girl? In person, over text, with or without your friends, or even if it helps to have her friends there or not? Thanks. People are super, like, anti-text when it comes to romance. When they don't realize that, like, not too long ago, bitches were getting proposed to through telegrams, you know, by some Russian prince. It was arranged for them. That was romantic in the day. So, you know, calm your tits, gentlemen. So this is how I would phrase a text. If you're around, we're gonna go out. It is it's a way to give that person two options, very casually, but also stating that you're confident, like, bitch. But if you are gonna do it over the phone or in person,
Here's how I would play it.
Hello, I know you're watching this. First, I'm beautiful. Second, you could use some work. Third, when it is not potentially lethal to be in the same room as you, you're gonna come over to my place, I'm gonna make pizza bagels, and then I'm gonna talk to you about how much I appreciate you, and then you can teach me how basketball works, and then we're gonna watch a couple episodes of Psych, and I'm gonna fall asleep, and you can find your way out of my home. Cupid is not my middle name, it's Ariel.
Hi, I wanted to know if you could give me advice on gaining confidence. Psychologically torment insecure women. Next question. Dear Caroline, this year, like the past 19 years of my life, I'm single on Valentine's Day. Whoops. You see, I like money, but I also like women. But women are sometimes expensive if you want to impress them. So here's my question. How can I have the cheapest Valentine's Day?
Cheap whores. Next question.
My friend put me on with a girl he liked and who... No, this is too long. Sorry. Oh, fuck. This is long, too. Do I even have time? Okay. Hello. I am not all right. Okay, fair enough. I am realizing things that... I do not want to realize these thoughts are happening during the day. They usually come between 2 and 4 a.m., you see, and are causing me to give up upon many things. For example, colors aren't real. Think about it. Why are all the colors that I see normal, but the colors that a colorblind person sees isn't normal? Because it's all that they see, so it's normal for them, but just because they don't see what I see, it isn't normal. You get what I mean? And my name isn't real. Well, like, I call myself one thing, but someone can call me another thing, but I'm still me, but not because it's my name. What the fuck, dude? In conclusion, how do I stop all of this? Actually, you don't have to even try answering this. I feel like you will just waste your time. Anyways, have a good day. First of all, you are not going to know the meaning of life. It's not your job to know, and you don't need to worry about it unless you're going into physics or... glorified circle jerking. What did they used to call it? Philosophy. Yeah. Go read a book about anthropology. Go learn how your eye sees color. And remember that if someone has a limitation, like a disability, physically speaking, they're gonna have like an accelerated ability in another area. So a person that's colorblind can see tone better than other people, tone that we wouldn't be able to perceive. Second of all, if none of that works, you can read Hegel. Good luck. Advice. I think I want to become a sugar baby. Well, that is quite the subject to an email. Hey, Caroline. I've been really fond of your channel since it started, and I really enjoy your content. It's helped me through hard times like my 8-year-long depression and toxic family. Awesome. I'd like to ask... TikTok has been recommending me more and more videos on sugar babies, showing me how much money they earn. That... This is the problem with TikTok. It's not... I also watched that one stripper movie with Jennifer Lopez last night and got to thinking. Wasn't the moral of the story, like, don't end up doing that shit because you'll be arrested? I'm broke and I need money for my weeb shit. Valid. Should I become a sugar baby instead of getting a fucking job? I'm almost 16. I'd appreciate any advice with concern and platonic love. Here's what I will say. No. Like, no. Don't be a sugar baby. I have nothing against it. If you're someone who went to college, had a job, was like, this isn't fulfilling, I need to find, like, a more free way to live my life, sure, become a sugar baby. But if this is the beginning of your life, nah. Figure it out first. Before you take a really extreme option, because it's not like it's a bad option, it's not like it's a wrong option. There is no wrong option other than, like, really hurting people. You are providing a service, but the problem is that you will potentially be hurting yourself, and that's not really worth it, especially because you're so young. I don't know what you should do. Not that option, though. Not yet, at least. But if it's still a good idea, like 5-10 years down the road, awesome. Do it. I highly recommend. I'm addicted to weed, frozen pizza, gaming, and lesbian porn. What should I do, Caroline? 16, male. Keep doing it until someone tells you to stop doing it, and that person will not be me.